Damn!
Yo, this is awesome. That's insane.
Do you like it?
I love it.
Did you like it when you saw it? It's crazy, right?
I get to tour the country meeting my fans. Not to go and perform and this and this. I'm literally touring to go house to house, door to door, apartment to dorm room to this to that, to meet my fans, play them my album before anybody else in the world gets to hear it.
My name is Ernie. Being the first person, I think, made everything harder on me just because I was already nervous, but now I'm like extra nervous.
I don't even know what to think right now. Like, I'm excited and I'm kind of nervous at the same time. I shouldn't be nervous, but it's like more of excitement right now. Kind of anxious. Been waiting all day for this shit.
I've been listening to Logic since late 2011, about 4 years now. Almost 4 years to like the day.
Hey,
what's up, man?
Nice.
Thank you.
How you doing?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. This is crazy.
I'm so excited right now.
Where do you live?
I'm right there.
Let's do it.
And then,
wow.
Yeah, that's your vine right there. That one was from the Under Pressure tour.
Will Turner. Huh?
Yeah. And then this right here is actually John Bellion on the number one too.
Oh,
number
shit. Dollar.
But the $5 bill one was from, you did a little interview at Backside at Burbank. It was like 20 people.
You came there?
Yeah, I was there.
Wow.
So, pretty much, like, even though all these vinyls and stuff, like, they're older hip-hop and things, like, Logic's vinyl was my first one. And, like, during the periods of times where he would work on a different project and the music wasn't really coming out consistently, I started listening to his mixtapes and, like, seeing what he sampled. So, like, I always knew who the Roots were. I always heard about Tribe and stuff, but, like, he's the reason why I started actually listening to it.
Now this, that's 40, yody, dope, malicious, hella vicious. I wonder where is this, hold up, get the fuck out my business. Show enough, we roll up, then load up, just a bastard, born in a wedlock, close to the earth like a dreadlock. Got my sights on deadlock, visions of my enemy in a headlock. Feel like I'm living in bedrock, surrounded by rubble. Just a youngin' in trouble, took a shot and it made it a double. Took a shot and it made it a double, that's that food for thought. My school ain't taught me good, no ingredients in my hood. But a tablespoon of this baking soda gon' make it good like it should. That's ignorant, isn't it? Hold up, wait, now take a look at my pigment. Tell me again, we can never begin based on the color of my skin. But in fact, your lips ain't thin. That's a club I don't want to be in. My DNA get done integrated. My God is innovative. That's a million miles away from
the. They talk about how Thalia can be any person from human history that's been documented, which is really ill. And then Kai picks Big Sean. Funny thing about that is, I was actually in the studio. Sean has an app where you can play all of his, like Lil Bitch and like Woe Dare and like all these things. Like, it's like a soundboard. And so I wrote him into it. This is my homie, and I knew he would do it for me. But so when we were in here, I just did it, and it was Lil Bitch. And that was it until I was gonna get the audio from him. So I called her and I was talking to him probably over the span of like 6 months. Cause he's a very busy guy and he's a good person. Sean's a really good person, he's amazing. So like a month goes by and he like doesn't send it to me. So I like shoot him a text like, hey, can you still do that thing? So the day before I went to master the album, the day I went to master the album, I got on a flight at LAX, and it's 4 o'clock in the morning, and I'm going through security, and then all I hear, hey, what's up, player? And I turn around, and it's Sean, right? And he's like, oh my, he's like, what's up, dog? And I'm like, what's good? And I tell him and Zeno and like all our homies all know each other, so we're like, oh, what's up? And the first thing he's like, yeah, I need to do that thing for you, man. And I was like, yeah. He's like, well, fuck with me, we can do it right now. So I was like, all right, shit, let's do it.
What up, Kai, you little bitch?
Oh my God. The day before I was able to turn it in to master the album. You know, so it's crazy how shit like that works out. It's really awesome.
Well, first of all, they mean everything because they don't really realize it. But like without them, I wouldn't be able to like live my dreams, you know. A lot of people who are in the limelight like to make it seem as though the fans need them, but it's really the other way around.
It's been cool to see Logic as like small Logic, you know, like he was saying, like 4,000 followers, mm-hmm. and being there from that to seeing him here, where like he's actually like a staple in the game. He actually is doing things people are gonna build off of. And to see that he's still giving back like he was.
And it's crazy how much he like remembers all his fans. Yeah. Like that he was like, oh, the first time I met you guys at House of Blues, right? Like you meet thousands of people and you remember the first time you met two fans. It's crazy, it shows how much he really does care about his fans.
Yeah. I remember 4 years ago, he tweeted, everybody tweet me now because eventually I won't be able to get back to everybody.
True.
You know, I was tweeting the hell out of him, but it's cool that 4 years later, you still see him connecting with his fans as much as he can, no matter what, even if it's, you know, his health, and it makes everyone feel so special.
Yeah, and then not that much artists get to do this for fans, you know, and it, I guess it makes you feel special about this.
This really for shows, sure. like, yeah. how much he cares about
yeah.
his fans.
Yeah. It's great to support him.
Yeah.
And Jessica and everyone else behind it. So.
He always like talks about how much he cares for his fans, and that now you get to actually see, like mm-hmm. everyone will get to see how much he truly cares about like all of his fans.
So we're gonna have a surprise. This fan, I told him I was gone. He wasn't gonna get me.
We just count up paper tracks. Whoa,
I know I'm gonna get my beats back.
Oh, what's up, bro?
What up, man?
I got all these bitches that have me down. I hear
you like,
what? Nice to meet
you, man.
Nice to meet
you,
man.
Nice to meet you, man.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Oh my gosh, dude, no way! Oh my gosh, man.
What's up, bro?
Dude, this is doing? Crazy.
Did you know I was gonna be on the bus?
Dude, I thought about it, but he was so convincing. He like
right?
was
he went through the whole motherfucker gosh, like, oh no, man, Logic.
That's insane, man.
My name is Avante Gina, I'm 22 years old. So I've been a Logic fan for about 3 or 4 years now. One of my friends introduced me to him right after he released Undeniable. So since then I've been a huge fan. There was a time where I was going through this whole thing with this girl, you know, like every other guy has been through. And at the same time, Logic had just released the song Let Me Go. And that song resonated with me for sure. And, you know, he just always kind of drops in things about his ex that he would talk about on his mixtapes and stuff like that. And it would make me realize that I'm not the only person that's going through these kind of things.
I was in a relationship, broke up. The song Let Me Go, I don't know what it was about it. It came on, I broke out into tears. And to the day, like listening to the song, it still kind of hits home with me. I don't cry anymore about it. I'm a big girl now about it, but that one hit home for me. It was definitely something personal for me.
Let Me Go was actually one of the songs that I heard, and whatever I was going through at the time, Let Me Go is a song about like a breakup, and like whatever I was going through, I didn't think anybody could really understand or relate to, so to say. And so when I first heard that song, like he pretty much captured every single feeling and every emotion.
And I was like, dang, those lyrics are deep as hell. But at the same time, like keep in mind, like I just like got like my heart broken up, like so to say. And like the lyrics he was saying was like what's going on with my life, and I was like, what the hell, like this is like fate or destiny. So I went home, I texted him, I was like, hey bro, so who was that rapper you were telling me about? It was like Logic, dude. I was like, all right, for sure. So I went home, and then I found All I Do, then I found Ballin', then after that I found the Young Sinatra mixtapes, and I was like, this Nick, like, you know, like he's a goat. I was like,
Logic has been one of the biggest influences on my life, and I think so for thousands and thousands of people. You know, I think it's a big blessing. You know, I think God chose Logic himself to be the kind of person that is just out there, and he's showing people a positive message. He's there in the rap scene where nowadays it's just getting to be hopeless and Logic is filling the rap game with hope. And we see people like him promoting peace, love, and positivity. And it's artists like that who make you feel like, you know, he's just like us. He resonates with us, he understands us. And it just makes you feel, you know, yeah, he's a real human being and he understands what we're going through and he can relate to everything we're doing and he's doing everything he can for his fans. And that's what's so great about him. That's what sets him apart from all the other rappers that I know, because I've never seen any rapper do what he's doing for his fans.
Logic is my idol. Like, found his message, peace, love, and positivity, like, when I was in 10th grade. So I've been following him for about, like, going on 3 years now. I know, it's been crazy. Like, everything he's done for his fans, especially for me, like, it's changed my life, like, for real. Then he brought someone on stage to rap 5 a.m. with him at the same time. And, like, I ain't gonna be saucy or whatever, like, all up to him, but I felt like, man, I would've killed it better, you know what I'm saying? I was like, man, if I was up there, I would've killed it, what the heck? And so after the show, that's all I kept on, like, saying, like, over and over to everybody. I was like, dude, next time I go to the Logic concert, I'm going to rap Roll Call with him. It's my favorite Logic song, Roll Call. My friend Keanu, it was me, Keanu, and Liam. Like, we're like the three, like we always listen to Logic, always, like, all the time, all the time. Only me and Liam got meet and greet tickets. And Keanu was, like, bummed out. He was like, oh, like, you guys get to meet him, like, I don't. He was just sitting on the weight bench out there, just looking all depressed. He was like, yeah, like, it's gonna be cool, but it's not gonna be better than the first one. I was like, no, dude, like, I have a plan, like, I'm going to make sure that you get to meet Logic free of charge. And I'm like, I'm going to rap with him so good on stage, and we're going to go on his tour bus after, and you're going to meet him free of charge. He was like, yeah, like, whatever, like, sure. Show starts. He comes out the Soul Food. He points at me. And I'm like, I look at Liam, like, what the hell? Like, this nigga really pointing at me? I look back, and his eyes get big, like, yes, I'm pointing at you. I'm like, no way, this is crazy. Show goes on, and it comes down for 5 a.m. He stops the music. He goes to Lenny, and he gets his painting from this dude. And he's like, so you get to come on stage. And he points to someone else. Bro, my heart is broken, dude. Like, everyone around me, like, looks at me and are like, damn, bro, I'm sorry. Like, this is your dream. And then, like, I'm looking down and, like, I'm wiping the champagne on my eyes. I'm looking up. And everyone in the crowd is looking at me. And the show is quiet. Like, he stopped the music and everything. And I look up. Logic is just pointing at me, bro. Like, he stopped the whole show. And everyone in the crowd is looking at me. He points at me. And I look up. And he's like, you. And I was like, huh? He's like, you. Like, yes, you. Like, come on stage. And I'm looking at Liam as I'm walking up. I'm like, oh, shit. In my mind, I'm walking. I hear Eminem's Lose Yourself in your ears. Like, I only got one shot. It's just like, oh, I'm about to kill this. So I get on stage. But I wasn't nervous because I already dreamed it, bro. And it's like, if you, like, truly, like, this is, like, my message to everyone out there. If you truly believe in anything, like, you can do it. Like, and Logic is living proof. So I just, like, applied his philosophy to myself. And I was like, okay, like, I'm here now. Like, I already know what's going to go down. He was talking to me. This is insane, dude. Like, this is my idol. Like, I used to be, like, sad and depressed, you know? Like, I'm so open about it because, like, I can be open about it, you know? Like, a lot of people don't have the strength to be that open, but, like, I was, like, depressed, dude. And then, like, knowing that my idol, like, put me on stage, told me that my letter was the best thing he's ever read in his life. Then we rap Roll Call, bro, my favorite song. We rap Roll Call. Then we do, like, the Miss Jackson, everyone's going crazy. Then after that, he's like, hopefully today's the best day of your life. Takes off his jacket, bro, comes and gives this chain on my neck, dude, in front of everybody. Crowd goes in an uproar. It was like the loudest the crowd got all night, dude. And it was like, that part I did not fucking philosophize and everything. So it was like, and then after that, to top it off, he like brings me up to the front of the stage and like lifts my arm up like I'm like The Rock or some shit. And I was like, no, this is crazy. Then after he hugs me, he tells me, thank you. And I look at him, like, even on the Just Another Day 30, I look at him, I'm like, nah, like, no, thank you. I look at him, like, what the hell? He's like, don't worry, I'll see you backstage after the show. John Berg, Ron John Berg, he comes, he gets me, Liam, and Keanu. We go backstage and chill with Logic for 30 minutes. So not only did, like, I say what happened, like, I let my best friend, like, meet him free of charge. I rapped with my idol on stage. I got his chain, and this is the first time I've ever met him. Like, that was, like, my first experience to actually meeting Logic, and, like, it was that crazy.
You got Twitter, right?
Twitter, yeah.
So I want you to do me a favor. Once you get it all booted up, I want you to tweet, I'm with Logic right now, or he's at my house, playing a video game with me, and then I'll go on my Twitter and retweet it and be like, yeah, come watch me play video games right now.
All right.
Okay. Oh, that's sick.
I'm down.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
You have $44?
Oh,
45?
Wow.
For like, really?
How many did you have before?
Zero.
Zero.
Yeah. Keep donating. for only $3.95 a month. You can support.
I'm just kidding.
In the arms of the angel.
Put some Sarah McLachlan on.
I know. That's it. It just make you feel bad. Throw the puppy dog eyes on there. You can help a beautiful young gamer. Damn, dog. Sick. First of all, PlayStation for life. Okay. What's your donation? His donation is $48. If you guys get the kid to $300 in the next 10 minutes, I will release a song tomorrow. What? I will release a song tomorrow if you donate. Get the kid to $300 in 10 minutes. It could literally be a buck or this or that, but if out of the 1,000 people, just some of y'all do that, it's a wrap. I'm gonna have to release a song tomorrow.
They get him $300 and he's gonna release his song tomorrow.
Yo, who wants that new song tomorrow?
What song you dropped?
I don't know, I'm gonna drop something crazy, man.
Yeah.
I don't know, I'm the greatest, it might be something else, it might be something crazy.
Who knows what's gonna drop tomorrow? Who knows? I mean, come on, listen to this. Listen to all of it. Oh, you want some swag. Listen to this right here. Come on, I'm done now. That's what you got. Like, come on, let's go. All
right, I gotta get out of here. I've been...
Wait, 300? What the fuck?
No.
No.
What the fuck?
No.
Dude, what the
new
fuck?
New song tomorrow.
$170.
What the fuck?
Surprise!
Yo!
Yes! New song!
What the fuck? How he just helped me? Like, I have like $532 right now. Just because of him in this, like, I don't know, what was it, like 30 minutes? You know, I have 30, or like 500. I have enough to even get myself a new motherboard and RAM. All thanks to him. Yeah. I'm gonna improve this just because he, like, inspired me. Like, he's like, yeah, do your thing. Do what you love. I'm gonna absolutely do what I love. Make video games. Like, videos of video games. Yeah, man, it's crazy. Can't believe that actually just happened.
About traveling space and time, I think about specific moments that I could rewind, not to redo it but relive it. I could give it one more go about and truly understand the deeper things that I don't know about. Now take a trip with me and vibe. I'm on this interstellar mission, issue down a ride. Hold up, I know this intermission, feeling like the tribe. Life is beautiful, I'm so lucky to be alive. I'm gonna take this moment right now, hitting school to people. I know deep in my heart everyone is created equal. I truly wish that I could see the sequel of our people. Truly wish that I could check it. Yeah, now when I hit the road and tour the world, I see like different, like this music shit, this ain't the world. Brothers and sisters from different mothers and misters, all different colors and creeds, all come together for me. Boy, I'm blessed to be free.
This is our time. Still I'm looking back at me. Rewind. This is our ride. Don't let me lose my faith.
Doing 70 on this highway. On the front of this bus, I'm busting my mind open, hoping these lyrics will keep me coping. On the grind like coping, no time to bring the doping, but this night will got me feeling lit. It's been like 3 months since I've been home. Sometimes it feel like forever, just how long I've been gone. Yeah, you know that's the shit that I've been on. You know I love it, feel like it's never enough of it. Let me bring him back. Chillin' watching Tarantino, we know I've been on it forever. My endeavor like a feature film, step into the realm of the realest. Do you feel it? I'm in it, my limit, the chillest. Let me bring him back, yo. Yeah, I woke up early on my born 25. It's a blessing, progression, everyday lessons got me stressing, but I'm testing, reminiscing when I would listen to my intuition. And now I made it, resurrect the young Sinatra I created. I'm elated, it seemed like everyone somehow related. Letters back and forth from my homie that's locked up in prison, doing 14, it's been 5, I know my heart's with him. I've been so busy, it felt like forever since I hit a man.
Unfortunately, man, we had some like amazing contestants in Indianapolis, and we're not gonna be able to make it, but please know that Logic sends his regards, man, and he appreciates your video and all the support.
Yeah, man.
What is it?
Are you kidding me, dude?
How's it going? Did he just call you? What's up, bro?
You should tell you.
Oh my gosh.
Were you upset? Were you? Were you right? Let's go upstairs.
We were dead seriously silent.
I felt really lightheaded when he like opened the door, and I was just like, he's right there.
I can't even take a still picture.
This is awesome.
Holy crap.
Yeah, like since he was, okay, so like when he was promoted by FaZe, you know, I was like looking at FaZe like I want to be like them one day, but you know, not the sniping element, but you know, just a YouTuber. And they were like, hey, there's this rapper named Logic. He's really inspirational. He's real. You know, he's just a great, genuine dude. And I was like, okay, I'll look him up. So I did. And it was like, holy crap. Like this dude knows my life. Like it was just like, it just clicked.
Hey, what's up, man?
What's up, fool?
What's going on?
I'm here with one of your fans.
Yo! No, no way! Dude! Temper!
What's up, bro?
Adapt!
Dude!
Holy crap! Yo, what's up?
These kids love you, man.
Dude!
What's up?
Yo!
What's up,
Adapt, oh my
temper,
gosh!
No way!
No.
Awesome. Oh, that's dope.
Oh my god!
Bro, you guys got to meet Logic? That's dope.
He's just so real. You know? It just... Because I was watching a lot of interviews and stuff like that, and I was like, oh, you know, this guy seems pretty cool. And then he came to the door, talked the same way. It was like, oh my God, you're the same person. He's still not arrogant about it, and that I think that's what people love most about him is how real he is and like how he just doesn't care about like, you know, the popularity. He's just like, I'm just doing my thing. And then people are like, oh, that's awesome and admirable.
I saw this really funny meme the other day of, it was other rappers versus Logic. And it was like all these rappers with like pouring bottles and throwing money. It was like legit and all these chains, which are fine. Those are okay things, right? And then you had me, and it was like a picture of me in like my jumpsuit in a Rubik's Cube. And I was like doing this really funny face or whatever. And it's like, I'm so glad that that's how people perceive me. They look at me like that. Because it's okay to have chains, bitches, bottles. That's totally okay. But I'm just so proud that I'm breaking the what's a rapper or what's a this or what's a that. And a big part of that is just being a good person and just being yourself. And yeah, there's 100% ego that comes with rap. And I have a humongous, it's just unmatched ego. There is nobody better than me. I am the best rapper, musician, artist, whatever that has ever existed when I'm in the booth and when I'm on stage. Because I have to have that mentality. Because you have to be your own biggest fan. You have to tell yourself you can do it. And then, dude, away from that, when the mic is set down and I'm out of the booth or away from that stage, you know, I'm just like, yo, where's the anime and the Pop-Tarts at? Like, yeah, I'm just a regular dude, you know what I mean?
Yo, I gotta take a picture of this.
Last year, I went to 5 shows in total. And I told 6 that I would try to top that and go to at least like 5 or 6 shows next tour. I want the name of your album.
The Incredible True Story?
The Incredible True Story. Because like my tattoos to me, that they tell my story.
Yeah.
And like this is an important memory to me. So like the Incredible True Story, like referring to like my story, yeah, but 100%. Referring to like yours.
Where do you want it?
I'm not sure.
I think about the impact others had on me. Because I'm just passing it down. That's all it is, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just a dude. Like, I'm just a guy who really loves music, and I know what I do.
Good.
I know what I preach, I know what I practice, okay. I know the message that I'm inflicting, and I know what this is doing for not only these people, but the people watching right now. And not just for myself, but for them to be like, whoa, like, I could do anything I want.
I've always been perceived as a black kid that's always talked white and not been the everyday stereotypical black kid. I've had that moment just many times throughout my life, and this music just connects it with every moment.
I've suffered. I have a lot of due to the things that I've been through, you know, certain obstacles that I had to go through and certain things that I had to face. There has been times where I've been down in the dumps, and there's other times where I've been, you know, high as me on top of the roller coaster and on top of the world. But for most of the time, There's been moments where I feel like listening to his music or somebody else's music that inspires me or that I like has almost saved my life.
A couple weeks later, I had another surgery, and then I was kind of like down on myself. I didn't really know like what was next and stuff like that. So I put on As I Am, and that kind of like helped me kind of like deal with the problem and stuff like that, to know that it'll get better. And then a couple weeks later, I had another surgery, and that I was really like depressed. I didn't have a sense of living. I just didn't feel like my life was worth something. And then I played As I Am again. I played all these other songs that are really deep and really like mean a lot to me. He helped me get through the hard times when I couldn't find anything else to do. I guess he kind of helped me leave depression and stuff like that. So.
And I tell him very straight on, I'm sure I sound a little blunt right now, but it's because that's the way it is. It's like, no, like you're so important, you're so smart, you're such an incredible person, that don't let anybody tell you what you can and can't do. You know what I mean? Especially yourself, because these people will let society incept their mind of what, it's like, okay, hey, let's keep it 100, all right? You're probably not gonna run the mile in like, you know what I mean? Like such and such time. Like, okay, that's cool. You know, but you can run laps past me, around so many people mentally with how smart you are. You know, so take what you love and do that. You know what I mean? Hell, honestly, let's be even real. Who's to say that kid can't run the mile in such and such? Maybe he's the mind that creates, you know, these prosthetics or this or whatever that could help the next generation of mankind. Like, dog, it's crazy, man. Like, any of these kids could like do anything. So I'm trying to be extra like, yeah, enjoy my music, but like, don't forget who told you. No, I'm just kidding. But like, yeah, dude, Tupac said that. I think he said, I'm not gonna change the world, but I'll definitely like touch the heart and mind of the child who will. That's kind of how I feel about it, you know what I mean? Except times a jillion. Like, I'm gonna talk to as many kids as I can. And people, it's not just kids too, man. Because I'll meet people in their 30s and their 40s, and like, yo, still, go live your dreams, go do it.
Guys, whose house is this?
This is the beautiful mother.
Oh my god, I thought you'd never come! Oh my god, you never come! Oh my baby, that's my sweetie! Oh my god! Let me look at you! Oh my god, I thought you'd never come! Oh god!
You excited?
Excited! Honey, I'm excited the whole week! What are you talking about?
My name is Angela. My last name is Mike. It's a little bit strange, but that's what it is. And I'm 52 years old, and I'm from Greece.
Oh!
This is amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you for coming.
Whatever, it's fine.
Okay. You hungry?
Yes.
Oh, my God. Are you Greek?
Oh, my God. When I saw him first time live in University of Maryland in College Park, I was so thrilled. We went outside right away after the show, it was over, and I said to my son, I said, I want to adopt him. I said, I want to adopt him. You know, if I could, I would, but anyway, that's how I feel. My son Angelo, you know, he introduced me to it. You know, he said, Mom, I want you to see this guy. He's younger, but he's so talented, and when I hear his music and I saw him, it just makes me happy. It makes me happy. I feel like dancing, you know? And I said, oh my God. And then I, you know, I wanna hear more and more and more and more. And when Angelo comes here, we just go upstairs and I'm happy just to hear him talking, singing, look at him. It's just the whole appearance is just awesome. He's just a I don't know, he's just cutie patootie. I call him America's sweetie pie. And I'm not making up these things. That's the way I feel. I don't know if I am just dreaming, if it's me, if it's not me, if I'm gonna wake up tomorrow. I'm gonna wake up tomorrow and I'm gonna think, it really happened. I'm gonna leave the house the way it is right now so I can, you know, get to me.
Awesome. Did you travel there? This is crazy.
How's that mean?
Tickets to Catherine. M. E. Marsh.
Congrats, Bob, you made it.
Bro, they're chasing us, bro. Look at this.
Oh, shit.
Look at the rocks, man. Look at that shit.
Holy fuck.
Oh, shit.
Holy fuck, bro.
Where's
I feel like I'm glad I pay people for security. Can you unlock
the door? The biggest thing that I learned when talking to all these people is that the message outweighs the music. But the message wouldn't be able to get to them if the music wasn't good. It's weird. So it's like, it goes to show how great the music actually is, but how the message itself is that much more important. The best part about the trip was starting and ending in two completely different places in my career. That was crazy.
This whole idea, I don't know if he created it or who, it doesn't matter. The fact that he's doing it is literally the coolest thing any artist has ever done. Not only in terms of just like being real, but just as like a business decision, like it means the world to me, like on my 23rd birthday for him to be here.
I want to say something to him, just, you know, thank you for everything. He really does make a huge impact on people, and I think he knows that, but you know, like it really is real. Like, he does influence lives, saves lives with his music, and it's incredible.
Like, the message, that's the thing. Like, people get so caught up in like music, but it's the message. That's why when I was downstairs when he played me the album, I was like, dude, your message, because it's more than music. Like, follow your dreams, for real. Like, that's what Logic instilled in me, and I'm going to instill that to the world.
Writers, but as everybody knows, you can't earn any money that way. What do you want to do? When we finally got down to something which the individual says he really wants to do, I will say to him, you do that. And forget the money. If you say that getting the money is the most important thing, you will spend your life completely wasting your time. You'll be doing things you don't like doing in order to go on living, that is to go on doing things you don't like doing, which is stupid, but it's absolutely stupid. Better to have a short life that is full of what you like doing than a long life spent in a miserable way. And after all, if you do really like what you're doing, it doesn't matter what it is. Somebody's interested in everything. And anything you can be interested in, you'll find others who are. But it's absolutely stupid to spend your time doing things you don't like and to teach your children to follow in the same track. See, what we're doing is we're bringing up children and educating them to live the same sort of lives we're living, in order that they may justify themselves and find satisfaction in life by bringing up their children, to bring up their children to do the same thing, so it's all wretch and no vomit. It never gets there. Therefore, it's so important to consider this question: what do I desire?
The incredible true story and transformation of the man who saved the world.